A very good morning to all. Welcome back to the second part of lecture on dental caries. I'll be speaking under the following contents. First, classification of caries, then various diagnostic aids in the caries, then I'll be talking about prevention of the caries, then I'll be talking about various caries control methods, followed by the sequelae of caries, and thus I'll be concluding my topic. So after we finish this topic, we should be able to answer the following. These are the learning objectives. Classification of caries. We should know what are different methods to diagnose the caries. Then caries control methods, sequelae of caries, and what is the sugar substitutes. Coming to the classification, the most common classification used in dentistry is the J.P. Black's classification. He classified caries into six classes. Class one is the occlusal surface caries on the premolars and molars. Class two is the proximal surface caries on premolars and molars. Class three is proximal surface caries on the incisors and canines without involving the incisal angle. Class four is the proximal surface caries involving the incisor and a canine with involvement of the incisal angle. Class five is caries on the gingival third of the facial and lingual surfaces. And class six is the caries on the incisal edge of the anterior teeth and on the cusp tip of the posterior teeth. Coming to how do we diagnose the caries? So there are mainly three methods: visual method, visual and tactile method, and the radiographic method. Coming to the visual method first, it is based on the use of a dental mirror, good lighting, and a clean and dry tooth surface. Examination based primarily on subjective interpretation of features such as integrity, translucency, opacity, location, and color of tooth are noted in this method. The drying of surface is an important part of this method because saliva can mask the difference in the reflection of light between caries and healthy tooth structures, thus hindering the observation of changes in color and brightness on the enamel surface. For example, you can see in this picture, that this is before drying, this is after drying. We can mark the difference between the, here we cannot see any difference, but here we can see the white radiopacity, so white opaque structure here, which is because of the dryness when the saliva has been dried. Then we can see the white flakes here that is seen as the demineralization of the tooth. So ICDS has given a criteria scoring for the caries tooth based on the visual examination. For the sound tooth, score is 0. For opacity with air drying is score 1. Opacity without air drying is score 2. Surface integrity loss score is given 3. Underlying gray shadow score is given 4. Distinct cavity, if you can see, that is score is 5. And for extensive cavity, score is 6. Next is the visual and tactile examination. In this method, along with the dental mirror, we also use the probe for the examination. And in this method, we see for the texture that we don't see in the first method, visual method. In this, we can, along with the integrity, translucency, opacity, location, and color, we can also see the, or we can also feel the texture of the caries. If you can feel the cache, it means it is a carious lesion. For the proximal surfaces, we can use the floss, as you can see in this picture. We can use the floss. If there is a catch, if there's a caries there, the floss will be attached there, or floss will not come easily, and thus we can mark that there can be a proximal caries lesion in those tooth. Next method is the X-ray method. In this, first we have the conventional radiography. As caries process progresses, the mineral content of enamel and dentin decreases, resulting in decrease in the attenuation of X-ray beam as it passes through the teeth. And this is recorded on the image receptor. Radiographs that are significant in the caries include the intraoral periapical radiograph for the occlusal caries and bitwing radiograph for the proximal caries. We can see here, this is the occlusal caries. If we take intraoral periapical radiograph, we can see the occlusal caries here. And for the proximal surface caries, we have to go for the bitwing. This is the bitwing radiograph showing the proximal caries on the distoproximal surface of the lower molar. Radiographic scores to classify the proximal lesions have been given by the KID, And there are four scores. Score zero is for the absence of any radiolucency. Then score one is for radiolucency in outer half of enamel. Score two is for radiolucency on the inner half of enamel, which can extend up to the DEJ. Then score three is the radiolucency in the outer half of dentine. And score four is given for the radiolucency in the inner half of dentine. There is a picture showing the different caries involvement of the different tooth structure. This incipient caries involvement only the outer half of enamel. Then here till the full thickness of the enamel. Here extending till the in the outer half of dentine. And here we can see the caries severe. That is, it has gone beyond the more half of the dentine. So it is classified as the incipient, moderate, advanced, and the severe caries, as seen on the radiograph. Then is the digital radiography. In this, the performance is improved due to possibility of image manipulation, such as zooming, enhancing the contrast, density, brightness, or the brightness of the image. For example, you can see here, we can compare, this is a digital radiography. Here we cannot mark out any caries lesion, but if we can enhance the, that is the main advantage of this digitized radiograph. We can enhance the contrast. So once we have enhanced the contrast, we can see a minute initial enamel caries on the mesial surface of the mesial proximal surface of the molars. So how to prevent the caries? Once we have diagnosed the caries, there are different methods by which we can prevent the caries. First is by diet modification. In this, we restrict the eating of the sticky carbohydrates. We reduce the frequency of intake and also the type of carbohydrate being taken. Eating of the fibrous food, not the sticky food. Eating food that promotes the alkalinic saliva, or which also promotes the release of the more saliva. Thus to flush out any acid or to flush out any impacted food. So then is sugar substitutes. We should go for the non-keratogenic sugar substitutes. For example, we have sorbitol, xylitol, and saccharin. Then we can prevent the caries by use of a fluoride application. It can be used either topically or systematic. Topically, we use as a dentifrice or the mouth rinse, or we can also use it as a varnish, for example, as DuraFact and floor protector. There's a picture showing application of the fluoride on the tooth surface. Then systematically, fluoride can be given as the water fluoridation, salt fluoridation, or the milk fluoridation. Then is the fissure sealants. To seal the deep fissures, different methods have been used. First was the acid ash technique given by Benacor. Then cyanoacrylates were developed, later BIS GMA, and now the NuvaSeal, which is the newest material. It has been approved. It is the first approved BIS GMA material, NuvaSeal, that can be used to seal the deep fissures so that the food does not stagnate there and there is no acid production. And thus the caries is halted and does not initiate in those areas. Next is the prophylactic odontotomy. It was developed by Hayat in 1923. It is based on the concept of extension for prevention. For prevention of fissure caries on the occlusal surface, we can see here, where we can see there was a deep fissure here, but because of the prevention, because of the by the burr, we can remove the enamel surface on the periphery of the deep fissures, and thus we make this self-cleansing. So once this deep fissure becomes self-cleansing, food will not stagnate there, and there won't be any action of the bacteria on the food. Thus, there won't be any acid production, and thus the caries will not initiate in those in these areas. So this is the basic idea behind the extension for the prevention. So there are some caries control methods. It can be classified as chemical method and mechanical method. In chemical method, we have use of chlorhexidine. It reduces the number of bacteria in saliva. It is said that the use of 0.2% chlorhexidine mouth rinse twice a day reduces the salivary bacteria by 85 to 90%. In mechanical method, we have nylon toothbrush, which was first produced in 1938. Then after that, various brushing techniques have been used to prevent the caries or to control the caries. In this, we have a Bass method, modified Bass method, Stillman method, Charter method, Roll method, and Fons method. They are used in different circumstances. Then for the treatment of the caries, we have we can go for the restorations. For example, we can go for silver amalgam restoration, GIC restoration, composites, inlays, laminates, and so on, if the caries has already occurred. Coming to sequelae of retinal caries, if the caries is not diagnosed at the early times, at its early phase, and if the caries has progressed, it can lead to the pulpitis, then to the periapical lesions, for example, abscess, granuloma, or the cyst. So to conclude, caries is a bacterial infection leading to the dissolution of the tooth, and if not treated, it leads to its sequelae, leading to infection in the bone. Thus, adequate measures should be taken for its prevention and management. So we should be able to answer these questions. So how do we classify the caries? What are different diagnostic aids for the caries? And we can also write a short note on the prevention of the caries. So thank you so much for your present hearing. I hope this lecture was useful.